ethnomusicologists, and more. She calls it the Songwrites Apothecary Lab.
We are like shipwrights, you know, we build things. We build things that we want to be vessels to ferry people from one point to another point, one shore to another shore, or even through a vast, you know, uncharted terrain.
Ferrying people is such a great verb.
The result
thanks,
is
Esperanza
an album
Spalding.
Of sonic concoctions, each with an intended effect on the listener.
Go with that
some
apothecary
are for stress
theme.
Relief or opening the
All
heart.
Things considered.
Others are a little more practical.
Like my mother, when I asked her what she needed a song for recently, she was like, I need a song to help me keep on schedule. So I wrote her this song she could listen to every morning that was kind of structured as a reminder of what the week was going to be like to just kind of keep her encouraged.
Amazing.
I don't know if it's the function of the song, but she has this song now that she wants to listen to at a certain time every morning. So it's almost like she's using that song as like the raw material to change her relationship to this issue. And I think the music that we're intending to make in the lab is skating through that spectrum, you know, a very suggestive and kind of abstract and poetic in its application to very specific. And what grows out of the lab is so much in response to the way that people in the lab and the guests coming into the lab respond to that question, what do you need a song for?
Sounds like fun. I need a song for fun.
Well, let's talk about the music specifically, how like each of these tracks, you know, they're set up with a particular function. Each of them has a specific, quote, intended use and effect. Those are your words for the listener, right? For example, like number one is, quote, designed for memorizing, then hearing internally as an aid to self-soothe during an acute moment of stress in the home. That song in particular, like how did you go about designing the effect on the listener?
Absolutely. I mean, the intended effect, the invited effect, I should say. Well, I was stuck at home with my beloved family, who I loved to pieces, obviously, and noticing that I hadn't actually been around them for a long period of time in a very long time. So, you know, you get past that, like, yeah, it's nice to see you. And you get into these moments where it's like, there's no place to go. You're just in like a crackling static, you know, all that old family history stuff.
Yeah.
That it's like everybody's kind of like doing the thing that, you know, bothers the other person and you can't really escape. And there's just this like frequency of stress. And I was thinking like, for these moments when I need to stay in the room and I can't go, it'd be so cool if there was something I could activate internally. So at least like within my vessel, I'm at ease. Or I feel like I'm full of a sound that, you know, it's almost like, you know, if the container is full of water, there's not room for the other water to get in, you know, or there's not room for the other thing to pour in.
In around the walls of your heavy-minded palace, suddenly the air goes miraculously